So if you grew up in the 80s, if you're Filipino, or if you wanted to be a performer, or if you're Catholic, you will get this piece. Everything is true in this story. We were the first Filipino family to move into Clinton, Maryland. It was so long ago, we came in on Carabao. I called our entrance the Little Meatball Hut on the Prairie. As soon as we moved into our new home, my mom, who's a nurse, a hypochondriac, and super Catholic, started making the sign of the cross with Lysol. I have two sisters named Faith and Charity. My name is Reggie. There is no hope in the family. While I was growing up, my mom would say, Reggie, why do you want to sleep over the neighbor's house there? They will murder you. Why don't you practice your piano lessons? My mom gave me piano lessons because for Filipinos, it was like old-fashioned karaoke. And my mom wanted me to entertain all the Filipino doctors and nurses. Reggie, come on now! Play me the cats! Play me the memory! God, what is this boy? Reggie, that played me the cats and let buy you the video games. Come, play! Okay, mom. Midnight, now the someone is crying. I am beautiful dear. Everybody was sipping Pepsi and hailing her a Filipina Barbara Streisand. At night, she made me and my two younger sisters pray the rosary in front of a 4-foot Mary statue standing on a huge green serpent. I called the statue Our Lady of Loch Ness. Reggie, what is the first honorable mystery? Well, Mom, they all range from sorrowful to boring. Could I please watch Dynasty now? Reggie, if you watch Dynasty, you will Dynasty. And it doesn't matter if I put you on the other road. Look at Romeo Del Rosario. He's on the other road all the time and going to give full scholarship at St. Christopher's School of the Glorious Ascension and Immaculate Conception of the Sea and Stars. But Mom, I don't want to go to all-boy Catholic school. Mom, I saw the movie Fame, and I could see myself in New York City, breakdancing on top of lunch tables and taxi cabs. I want to go to the Duke Ellington School of the Arts in D.C. Reggie, who's the Duke Ellington? And why don't you see yourself modern dangerous? Somebody will book your head there. Don't you know that I'm making sacrifices for you and sacrifices for you all the time? And how to stay in all my Catholic school, see? My heart is shaking with the gift of prophecy. Mom, that's arthritis. It is not arthritis. Remember when the statue of the Blessed Virgin Mother was in the living room? And when I went to take a shower, I reached for the shampoo. And the shampoo spilled on the tile in the image of the Blessed Virgin Mother. That is why Our Lady of Port Blas is watching over us. And she is telling me, tell Reggie he has to go to all-white Catholic school. And tell him to have girlfriend later when he is 30 years old because it would lead to mortal sins. I knew about sins because I went to confession every week. Father, forgive me for I have sinned. My last confession was yesterday. I know it's a sin to disobey your parents, but I scheduled an audition at the Duke Ellington School of the Arts. I already have a dance choreographed, and I need a 3-minute monologue. So I took Jennifer Beals' monologue for the movie Flashdance. She really doesn't have a monologue, but I strung all her lines together, and it just comes down to 3 minutes. Well, I never made it with the Duke Ellington School of the Arts. I was too avant-garde, too ethnic. Instead, I went to Bishop McNamara High School, where for my senior year, I got the title role in the play Dracula. But with all the white makeup on, I look like Yoko Ono. But I mean, I could be more than Yoko Ono. So I auditioned for television parts in DC. And I got a call back for America's Most Wanted. To be the Vietnamese serial killer. I told my mom and she said, Regina is so good for you. I know that will be the killer. So I will pray for you, I will pray for you. I will pray for you on Novena. I don't know if there's a patron saint or Novena to be a serial killer on America's Most Wanted. But it worked. I got the part and everyone in church was watching. He said, Mrs. Tabitha, your son was so great on America's Most Wanted. And she said, oh, well, yes. He was always very mean to me and his sisters. But I could be more than a serial killer. So I auditioned, and I got my first role as a servant. With no lines. I'd be coming home late at night, and I would see that my mom was up walking back and forth. Reggie! Where were you? I thought you died in a car accident. Come here, let me show you something. My mom leads me to the other side of the room, and there's a huge light. It was blinding. I didn't know what it was. Maybe the Blessed Virgin Mother had landed into our living room. It's like a UFO or something, supernatural like that. And as I got closer, I saw that it was a lighted glass stand with all of my awards. Mom, what's that? Reggie, this is your shrine. If you're an actor, do not do these soap operas, because it will lead you to sin. Reggie, if you're an actor, why don't you be like Oprah? Reggie, you are my Oprah. But now I'm just a servant with no lines. I'm not the patron saint you're in the great dreams. I'm not your Oprah.